The words modern classic are often thrown around when describing vehicles, but it takes a special car to actually live up to that label. It has to come from a universally iconic lineage, while being innovative to still be relevant on today's roads. Now, no matter how old you are, you've heard of the car from Britain that became a cultural icon back in the 60s, right? Its unmistakable silhouette, featured on magazines, websites, movies, toys, you name it. Well, here we are, over 60 years and 3 model generations later with its latest iteration. This is the Mini 3-Door Hatch. Hey guys, you're watching Rev, your ultimate guide to choosing your next ride. This week, we go behind the wheel of the latest Mini 3-Door Hatch. It is the latest edition of this iconic hatch that comes with 3 different variants. Ever since German company BMW took over the reins of the Mini brand back in 2000, they've introduced several generations of the iconic Mini Cooper. Throughout the years, they've gone on to become more and more advanced in terms of tech and design, but at its core, it remains the same charming hatch with a beloved heritage all over the world. Fast forward to 2021, and seeing a Mini on the road is still a head-turning sight that puts a smile on everyone's face. If you're a young child, it's like seeing a toy car come to life, and if you're up there in age, maybe it brings you back to a simpler time when getting behind the wheel with a full tank of gas was all that mattered. While it's a small package, the Mini is considered a high-end hatch with a matching price tag. Today, we're driving the entry-level variant of the Mini 3-door that comes with a base price of 2,550,000 Philippine pesos. This particular trim comes with a 1.5-liter twin-power turbo petrol engine that produces 136 horsepower and 220 Newton-meters of torque. All that is mated to a 7-speed automatic dual-clutch transmission on the front-wheel drive system. While we go through the ins and outs of the Mini 3-door, let's face it, its unique and iconic look will always be its main hook. There will always be new designs of sedans, rugged pickup trucks, and SUVs, but make no mistake, there are only a few cars on the road as distinct as the Mini. Mini has done a great job of preserving the heritage of the iconic hatchback while keeping it modern and up to today's standards. On the front grille, you've got the signature large grille with a chrome trim flanked by the classic round headlights with DRLs. Take note of the circular theme. We'll be seeing more of it throughout this Mini. You've also got a pair of LED fog lamps down below, as well as another vent on the bumper. Simple and classic is the theme of the front fascia, punctuated by the Mini logo badge. Looking at the side profile, it's more of the same clean aesthetic with the exception of the small vents near the front fender which add a little sporty character. The low slung flat top is a main design cue of the Mini's instantly recognizable silhouette. We're also fans of the two-tone 17-inch alloy wheels with propeller strokes and how good they look with black cladding on the arch. Also present is a thin metal trim that runs all around the Mini, which is a common design among the other lineups. We also like the contrasting colors on the roof and the circular mirror caps, which really help the Mini pop when you're looking at it on the road or from above. On the rear, just like other Mini models, it's very clean and minimalistic as well. The rear spoiler adds a sporty touch, and you've also got that Mini logo on a black glossy trim. Another unique callback to its British heritage are these tail lamps. Look closer and you'll see the Union Jack flag pattern design along with more chrome garnish. Completing the rear profile is a single chrome tipped exhaust and another low-mounted fog lamp. Overall, it is a balance of the design philosophy that's made the Mini so memorable, with an updated look that will always be in style. Like we said, a modern classic. If you're fans of the subtle, sporty look of the Mini 3-door outside, you'll even get a simpler and even bolder sporty treatment inside the cabin. As I mentioned earlier, that circular theme can be found around the car and inside too. The round elements are a signature trademark with Mini, and it's even more evident in the interior. From the air vents, the instrument cluster, infotainment screen, even your buttons for climate control and the door panels, they all share the same theme. You've got a combination of cloth and leather upholstery on the seats, and check out the bolsters, which remind you that this little Mini can go pretty fast. Going back to the details, it's mostly piano black plastics with touches of chrome, both on the door panels, the dash and the center console. While they still feel premium, a couple more soft touch materials here and there would have gone a long way. The three-spoke steering wheel is very sporty with a nice chrome trim. It also houses your basic audio and navigation controls. It is also telescopic, which makes it easy to adjust to your preferred driving angle. And check out the instrument cluster. It moves with the steering column to always make sure you always have it in view. The centerpiece of the front cabin is the biggest round shape apart from the steering wheel. You've got a 6.5 touchscreen with an LED accent light integrated to the several features of the Mini. Changing various settings to your audio levels, driving modes, and air conditioning give you different kinds of ambient light to choose from, which is a cool feature. The screen also shows your reverse camera and has a pretty nifty sports display when you engage sport mode. Unfortunately, no Apple CarPlay and Android Auto here, but connecting your phone via Bluetooth is pretty simple enough. The new Mini 3-door goes a step further with its sporty theme with these switches and toggles instead of the usual buttons. They are metal and have a nice heft to them, which adds premium to the cabin. My personal favorite is this bright red start-stop switch right in the middle, which makes you feel like you're about to power up a rocket ship. You've got just one USB port and power outlet up front, and alternative controls for your media right below the gear shift. Since this Mini is a 3-door, it comfortably sits two passengers up front with an okay amount of space in the second row. Don't expect much in terms of space and comfort features. You've got your standard cup holders and that's about it. As long as you're not driving above average sized adults in the back, sitting there shouldn't be too much of a bother for short trips. Opening up the trunk gives you a modest 211 liters worth of cargo. And if you push the second rows all the way down, gives you a considerable 731 liters worth of cargo space. All in all, it blends a lot of retro elements with modern implementation. You know, it's a modern car, but it still retains that classic feel because of the themes and design choices inside. Once you start the ignition, the Mini feels like it looks. Light, agile, and easy to maneuver. The suspension does put the ride more on the firm side though, but that's also due to the fact that the Mini runs on run flat tires, which are a must since it doesn't come with a spare tire attached. That's a common trade-off we're willing to accept for the added security and less weight. Step on the gas and you'll see that the twin power engine gives this thing quite a kick, especially in sport mode. Mini says this will go from 0 to 100 in 7.8 seconds. Honestly, it feels faster than that. Now, if you're used to driving larger vehicles and SUVs like myself, it might take some time to get used to the low height, especially when you see motorcycles zipping beside you. On the plus side, the Mini has great visibility both on the front and with those side mirrors bolted on the doors. Another thing we like is how well put together it feels on the road. It's not the fastest ride out there, but the one thing it has for sure is its tight handling. In terms of NVH, most of the noise you get inside the cabin is due to those run flat tires we mentioned earlier, but it's fairly quiet and behaved otherwise with minimal vibrations. Now, it's not every day that you get to drive something as small and as agile as the Mini. It feels like you're driving a fun toy car that can zip in and out of traffic and turn heads on the road while doing it. Now, we've established that the Mini handles on city roads pretty well. No surprises there. With its size, it's practically meant to be driven on tight Manila roads. Once you get some breathing room, the Mini shines, especially on some twisty roads to have some more fun on, like this. The Mini 3 Doors 1.5-liter twin-power turbo engine may not scream on paper, but it's more than adequate with a top speed of 210 kilometers per hour. As long as you're not overpacking your ride with cargo, this thing can overtake and breeze through the lanes on the highway with no problems. The Mini comes with three driving modes: green, mid, and sport. In green mode, the car feels a little sluggish and slow to respond, but it's focused towards fuel economy. Switching it to mid still holds the twin turbo engine back a little for better mileage, but turning on sport mode is where the fun's at. There is a significant weight added to the steering in sport mode, and it helps you feel more planted and secure, especially when you're going through those twists and turns at moderate to fast speeds. Now, aside from its looks, the Mini is known for its go-kart handling. And let me just say this, if ever you get a chance to drive a Mini, you know, and you get to drive it on roads like this, just do it. This is a perfect example that outright power isn't everything. You can have a lot of fun driving this without breaking the speed limit. Woo! Wow! This car is crazy fun to drive. The Mini 3 Door also has pretty good engine brakes to balance out all that playfulness. Shifting is also pretty snappy and responsive in sport, and we highly recommend leaving it there if you're in the mood to let the Mini show you what it can do. Again, this leans towards a firmer and sportier drive, so do not expect this Mini 3-door to be able to handle, you know, bumps on the road compared to larger SUV models. No, but regardless, this is a joy to experience because this is agile and active and perfect to drive out on the open road. In our short time with the latest Mini 3-door hatch, we'll sum it up as a unique driving experience. There's nothing quite like taking out a Mini on the road and feeling the heads turning as you zip along. For some, that charm alone is worth the price of admission. Add to that engineering that went into the design of the quirky modern interior, and you've got a stylish daily driver that's more than capable of giving you some fun on a daily basis. If you've ever dreamed of owning a one-of-a-kind hatch with a lot of history behind it, this Mini is waiting for you.